गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट अवर फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर दैट विच इज हैविंग प्रोग्राम नेम इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग. अवर प्रोग्राम कोड इज ईई. कोर्स टाइटल इज इंडस्ट्रियल एसी मशीन एंड सेमिस्टर इज फिफ्थ. अवर कोर्स कोड इज 225523. अवर यूनिट नंबर इज 5 एंड इट्स नेम इज फ्रैक्शनल हॉर्स पावर मोटर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कवर our course outcome for this particular unit number 5, which is use specific fractional horsepower motor for different application. Next one is we are going to cover program specific output related to this unit is maintain various types of rotating and static equipments. So here one is first we are going to cover our first unit outcome, that is explain working principle and construction of different fractional horsepower motors. So we are going to cover today topics that are introduction to fractional horsepower motors, next different types of fractional horsepower motors, construction of synchronous reluctance motor, working principle of synchronous reluctance motor, construction of switch reluctance motor and working principle of switch reluctance motor. So let's start with our introduction to what are actually FHP. So its name indicates that it is having horsepower which is in the form of fraction. Okay, so basically the fractional horsepower motor is an electric motor with rated output power of less than 1 horsepower. So see, if you see the horsepowers of different machines, so we have seen 2 HP motors, 1 HP motor, but the fractional horsepower motors having its HP which is less than 1. So for example 0.5, 0.7 HP, so that are included in your fractional horsepower motors. So they are designed and manufactured for specific job as per need of industry. So if we see there is a robotics industry, so there we need small motors for movement of hand of that particular robot. So there we require fractional horsepower motor where we have to perform small tasks with that particular machine. So there we use fractional horsepower motors. Fractional horsepower motors also finds its application in numerous appliances, equipments and machineries in various industries. So fractional horsepower motors are also used with pumps, compressors, refrigerators, washing machines and cutting tools. So let's see what are the different types of fractional horsepower motors we are going to learn in this unit. First one is synchronous reluctance motor, second one is switch reluctance motor, third one is brushless DC motor, fourth one is permanent magnet synchronous motor, fifth one is stepper motor and sixth one is AC and DC servo motor. So our quiz number 1, let's take one quiz related to topic covered till now. So which of the following is not a suitable application for fractional horsepower motors? I already told you that fractional horsepower motors are used where? In small tasks or in appliances, okay, in domestic appliances. So let's see which is not suitable application for fractional horsepower motor. So here are the options. First one is in different domestic appliances, small tools used in industries, at generating stations after turbine, and fourth one is water pumps. So the correct answer is at a generating station after turbine. Here we are not using fractional horsepower motor. At generating stations there is AC generator, which we call alternator. So our second quiz, which of the following is a fractional horsepower motor. We have seen different types of fractional horsepower motor. So let's see what are the options. First one is three-phase induction motor, servo motor, synchronous motor, alternator. So the correct option is option B, which is fractional horsepower motor, and all three are three-phase motors. Okay, three-phase induction motor, synchronous motor, and alternator are AC machines. Okay, which are having its horsepower or rating which is more than 1 HP. So the correct answer is option B, that is servo motor. So let's start with our synchronous reluctance motor. First we will see construction of synchronous reluctance motor. So we know every machine is having its main two parts in its construction, which is first one stator, second one is rotor. So let's see what actually stator made up of synchronous reluctance motor. So first let's see synchronous reluctance motor stator is of reluctance constructed with distributed and concentrated winding, consist of a frame and a core with the winding. If you see the diagram, you will see there is a stator core inside. Okay, there are stator slots in its periphery of stator core. It is having stator slots. Okay, there stator slots are included, or we say that stator windings are inserted in your stator core. Okay, which is of distributed or concentrated winding we are here used here, and the outer ear part you are looking, that is blue part, we called it as, it also called it as yoke. So the major function or main function of yoke is to provide mechanical strength to your machine and protect your internal construction. Okay, so the blue part you are seeing is what it called it as yoke, and inside we are seeing that stator core is there, where we put stator windings which are of concentrated or distributed types. So second diagram shown is giving detailed construction details. Stator core, you are seeing stator slots which are semi enclosed slots. Okay, so here we are going to put stator windings in these stator slots. Now second part of our construction is rotor. So there are three main types of rotor of reluctance motor, are distinguished as rotor with saline poles, an axially laminated rotor, and transversely laminated rotor. So see diagram shown is, first diagram shown is rotor with saline pole. So if you see in the diagram, you are going to see that poles are projecting out. Okay, so this type of construction called saline poles. So first rotor is it with having saline poles. So next you will see its name is axially laminated rotor. If you see the laminations of the rotor is in the form of axial format, so they are cut in axial length, so we called it as axial laminated rotor. And third type of construction for rotor is transversely laminated rotor. So here our lamination cut in the format of transversely. Okay, so hence we called it as transversely laminated rotor. So basically the rotor is made up of ferromagnetic material and it does not having any windings. So here is third quiz hour. Which of the following is not a type of rotor for reluctance motor? We already seen different types of rotor for reluctance motor. So the options are rotor with saline poles, cylindrical cage rotor, axially laminated rotor, and transversely laminated rotor. So the correct option is B, that is cylindrical cage rotor. It is a type of rotor which are used for your three phase induction motor, and other three are rotor type of reluctance motor. Okay, let's move forward to our working topic. Let's see how actually your synchronous reluctance motor works. So here term or name indicates that there is a reluctance. Concept is here. So what is reluctance? It is oppositions to flow of magnetic flux. So see, there is a stator core. In stator core there are stator slots where we put stator windings which are carrying current. Okay, we are going to provide electric supply or AC supply to our stator core windings. Okay, and rotor is made up of ferromagnetic material. Once you switch on your three phase supply to your stator winding, rotating magnetic field may get start or may get form in your air gap between rotor and stator. Okay, so due to this, rotating magnetic field will create some force on rotor which is made up of ferromagnetic material. So you know that basic principle of motor is whenever current carrying conductor placed in magnetic field, it experiences a force, or if there is a relative motion between your conductor or flux, okay, so an EMF is induced in conductor, which is the principle for your generator. Okay, so what happens here, your rotating magnetic field exerts a force on your rotor. Okay, so here form a reluctance torque in your air gap. Okay, due to that reluctance torque form, rotor tries to align with the low reluctance path. Okay, if you see, here are more magnetic fluxes. Okay, so here is opposition to magnetic flux is less, and where there is a low magnetic fluxes, that is there is high reluctance. Okay, so your rotor is going to align with where there are high magnetic fluxes, so you will get a motion for your rotor. Okay, so let's see detailed working of your synchronous reluctance motor. So first point is, when supply is given to stator winding, the revolving magnetic field will exert reluctance torque on the unsymmetrical rotor. Okay, next, hence tending to align the saline pole axis of rotor with the axis of revolving magnetic field, because in this position the reluctance of magnetic path would be minimum. So see, your rotor is trying to align with the low reluctance path. Yes, then if the reluctance torque is sufficient to start the motor and its load, the rotor will put into step with the revolving field and continue to run at the speed of the revolving field. Hence, actually the motor starts as an induction motor, and after it has reached its maximum speed as an induction motor, the reluctance torque pulls its rotor into step with revolving field. Motor now runs as synchronous motor by virtue of its saliency. So what concepts gives us that synchronous term is related? That synchronization, there is synchronization between your stator and rotor field. Okay, that is, if you having synchronous speed for your rotating magnetic field, then your rotor also starts rotating with that same speed. So there is a synchronization between your rotor एंड योर स्टेटर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, हेंस वी कॉल्ड इट एज सिंक्रोनस रिलक्टेंस मोटर. सो नेक्स्ट वी विल गोइंग टू कवर मूव फॉरवर्ड टू आवर सेकेंड मोटर, दैट इज स्विच रिलक्टेंस मोटर. सो हियर वॉट चेंज इज देयर इन नेम, दैट इज इन आवर फर्स्ट मोटर देयर इज नेम इज सिंक्रोनस रिलक्टेंस मोटर एंड हियर इज स्विच रिलक्टेंस मोटर. सो नेम इंडिकेट्स देयर इज अ स्विचिंग एक्शन इन योर मोटर. सो लेट्स सी वॉट हैपन्स एक्चुअली इन सिंक्रोनस रिलक्टेंस इन स्विच रिलक्टेंस मोटर. सो फर्स्ट लेट्स सी कंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर स्विच रिलक्टेंस मोटर. सो इट्स स्टेटर. ओके, स्टेटर ऑफ सिंक्रोनस रिलक्टेंस मोटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ सलाइन पोल्स ऑन स्टेटर कोर्स. सो हियर यू आर, इफ यू सी इन सिंक्रोनस रिलक्टेंस मोटर देर आर स्लॉट्स ऑन इट्स स्टेटर कोर. पेरीफेरी ऑफ स्टेटर कोर इज मेड अप ऑफ स्टेटर स्लॉट्स. ओके, बट इन स्विच रिलक्टेंस मोटर वी आर हैविंग सलाइन पोल्स ऑन इट्स कोर. ओके, सो इफ यू सी द आउटर ईयर पार्ट इज योक. ओके, दैट स्टेटर कोर, स्टेटर कोर इज हैविंग सलाइन पोल्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट स्टेटर कैरीज कॉइल्स ऑन ईच पोल. सो डायग्राम शोन यू दैट पोल्स इज हैविंग poles are wounded with coils. Okay, so the diagram diametrically opposite coils, if one coil is start here, then that coil will end its second side at actually vertical diametrically opposite pole. Okay, next if you see adjacent poles is having another phase coil and which is going to end with its exactly diametrically opposite pole. So the rotor is made up of soft magnetic material and it carries no winding. Okay, so it is having soft magnetic material. So the diagram shown rotor is, see, it is having soft magnetic material and both stator and rotor are laminated. Why we use laminated structure here? So by using laminated structure we are going to reduce our eddy current losses. Okay, what happens here actually when we reduce area for current conduction, so we, by reducing that area, we are reduce the actual loss which are eddy current losses. So hence by laminating we are reduces areas, hence we are reducing the eddy current losses. So see, let's see working of switch reluctance motor. So see, magnetic flux have tendency to flow through lowest reluctance path. If there is a low reluctance, so magnetic fluxes flow through that path. Therefore, rotor always tends to align along the minimum reluctance path. Okay. So the rotor is made up of magnetic material and it will tries to align with the low reluctance path or minimum reluctance path. If you see the first diagram, you will see A phase, B phase and C phase are there, and ending of A phase is shown as A phase, ending of B phase is shown as B dash, ending of C phase is shown as C dash. So see, once we give supply to our, or we, once we switch on the supply to our first phase, that is A phase, then a magnetic field or magnetic path created is shown in the diagram. Okay, your magnetic field is created and the path for flux is shown by that green dotted line. So if you see, here are the more magnetic fluxes and here are the low magnetic fluxes are there, or less number of magnetic fluxes are there. So here we form low reluctance path. So if you see, the rotor is aligned with your A phase, okay? So your rotor get attracted to your N pole, which is having here high magnetic field, that is low reluctance path. So your rotor is aligned with that particular A phase. See, when stator phase winding A is energized, the rotor aligns along a A phase. If you see the next diagram, in which B phase is energized. So if you energize B phase, the magnetic path will flow like this, okay? Now the magnetic fluxes are flow like this structure. So it going to flow like this. It covers this much path through your outer stator core. So here we see, here are main high magnetic fluxes, that is low reluctance path. Hence now your rotor C shifted to B phase, okay? It is switched to B phase because it is having here, we are having low reluctance path. So automatically your magnetic material, okay, your rotor is having magnetic material, it aligns with your B phase, which is having low reluctance path there. So here in this air gap is having low reluctance, so the rotor is aligned with B phase. Next, the third diagram shown, we are going to energize our third phase, that is C phase, okay? Hence path formed is such that, okay, now magnetic fluxes are flows like this, okay? It covers path through N pole and your outer stator core and are going to end with your opposite phase coil side, okay? So here form what happens, now your rotor is switched to third phase, that is C phase, where he got low reluctance path. So your magnetic material have tendency to align with your low reluctance. So if you see in the diagram, you will get here are more fluxes, that is low reluctance path. Hence your magnetic rotor is aligned with your low reluctance path, which is having here C phase. Thus the rotor rotation in clockwise direction is achieved by energizing the phase winding in ABC sequence. So if you sequentially energize the phases, A phase, B phase, C phase, then your rotor is going to switch to next position, okay? Hence we called it as switch reluctance motor. Let's take one quiz. So our first question is, which type of torque is produced in both synchronous and switch reluctance motor? So actually what happens when we put on our three phase supply, so there we got a reluctance torque. So here are the options. First one is reluctance torque, second one is synchronous torque, third one is motor torque, and fourth one is generator torque. So the correct option is first one, that is reluctance torque, option A. So okay, so the correct answer is reluctance torque, okay? Hence we covered today, we have covered two topics, that are synchronous reluctance motor and switch reluctance motor. If anyone is having any questions, they may ask us.